Yeah, Toastmasters, I'm a guest. Topic we're gonna discuss with you tonight is called the seat of eternity. Is any of you know what I'm gonna talk about? I'll put it another way. Anyone heard about doomsday storage? Anyone? Raise your hand. Yes, I thought. Only one respondent knew about it, so here we are. I didn't waste my time on the Georgian topic. It's gonna be interesting, I promise you. So off you go. The doomsday storage is actually storage based in Norway. It's a global sea vault, also known as doomsday storage, based in the city of Svalbard, Norway. I'm sorry for my Norwegian accent. Basically, my journey with Norway began in 2014 when I conducted a research for Institute of Economic Development of Kazakhstan. And not only I realized that Norway has a strong human potential, strong natural resources available for its citizens' use, but also it's ranked the first country in the world with a peace index ratio level. And it also was ranked in 2014 number one for the wealth and well-being. It is also donated $1 billion for saving the Amazon rainforest. But back to the topic, the Svalbard Doomsday Vault was established in 2008 by initiative of the Norwegian government, Bill Gates Foundation, and the Global Organization. So the main purpose of this foundation is to gather all the seeds from all around the globe to be maintained in one place. In case of global catastrophe, or earthquake, or nuclear war, all the seeds can be restored in the future, to be used by the general public. And when I realized that Norway has initiated this sort of program, I was stunned. It was fascinating me right from the beginning. I couldn't believe that actually in this world of greed, one nation, one country, has shown a great example of human generosity. And when I realized that the seeds, right now there are 365,000 seeds present in this bowl, has been taken over from all over the world, starting from Yemen and finishing in Latin America. So basically each nation, literally each nation in the world, has contributed at least one seed from their country to be put to be replaced in this bunker for future generations. And when I thought deeply about this matter, I was wondering, what have I done for nature? Not for my country, but for the nature, for this, for ecology. Because it's a serious matter nowadays. And when you see examples like Norway, you realize that small things matter. Because sometimes we take it for granted. Let's say oats, we all need oats porridge. And we take it for granted. Sometimes we waste it. We trash it straight away without even finishing it. And we think, oh, we have more of it left in our country, in neighboring countries, and so on and so forth. However, it's worth to mention that will end one day. One day, the seeds will not be there. And one day, Tiger Junior, in 100 years' time, will say, I want to eat Greshka. And there will be no Greshka left for him because of greed, because of mankind's lack of generosity at this moment, this particular moment. So, getting back to this, basically, the vault for doomsday storage is located in the mountain, literally in the mountain. It's covered by the snow and it's surrounded by polar bears. And I'm telling you, you shouldn't be messing with polar bears every point of your life. Trust me. Even I'm a bad guy, I don't mess with polar bears. So that's safe. That's my point. And it's located in a remote area of near the South Pole, so nobody literally can reach it without permission of your government. And right now, there are more than 1,000 employees working there, residing in this doomsday storage. But basically, We reside there only for like 2 weeks and then we leave. It's a shipping job because humans' body cannot persist even in this sort of temperature all around the year. And basically, it's located 1,300 kilometers away from the North Pole, from South Pole, sorry, and built right into a sandstone mountain and covered in a thick layer of permafrost. And according to the Global Crop Diversity Trust, an international organization which was one of the initiators of this initiative, the Doomsday Vault has been accessed only once by the country which already contributed the seeds to it. Guess what, which country? The Syria. The reason because the seeds they contributed before has been damaged due to the recent war, civil war. And it's been placed into the gene bank of Syria near the city of Aleppo. But due to constant bombings of the city, they had to withdraw some seeds to plant it again into the gene bank. So it's you know, it's a shame actually, because it illustrates again the greed drives sometimes human nature. In conclusion, I would like to add that there is a strong message for future generations. Sow a seed today so you can reap the harvest in the future. Greed has poisoned man's soul and has barricaded man's heart. But together, we can make a difference. Together, we can reap the harvest. Thank you.